Hi, class. Now, the next couple of modules, we're going to be talking about the different parameters that you need to be aware of whenever you're talking about composting and making your compost pile. There are several different parameters, and the first one that I'm going to cover is the carbon-nitrogen ratio. You often see it written as the CN ratio. That's a very important part of your composting as you're building your pile and knowing what you're putting in, the amounts of carbon, the amounts of nitrogen. And why is that important? Well, remember, we talked about what you're doing in composting is really your microbe farming. You're growing organisms, and you want to provide them with everything that they need so that they'll do the job you want them to do, which is breaking down all that organic material. So go back to the slide we brought out earlier. What do microbes need? Well, carbon. That's one of the things they need, because a lot of the carbon compounds are their high energy compounds. That's where they get their energy for the metabolism that's going on for everything they do. They need the carbon. Nitrogen, now they need nitrogen for the biosynthesis of a lot of the cell components and the different parts of this of their processes that are going on. For proteins, for enzymes and nucleic acids, they need that nitrogen. They also need water. That's for movement of the microorganisms in the compost pile. And water, of course, is essential for a lot of life functions. So water is needed. Oxygen, they need oxygen for respiration. They need a hospitable environment. And like I said, remember, you're microbe farming. That's what you're doing. As Chris mentioned earlier when he was talking about this, is they want food, they want shelter, and they want warmth. So microbes aren't a whole lot different from most living organisms and what they need and the things they require. So you see why they need carbon, you see why they need nitrogen, but it's the amounts they need and in what quantities, which is why the carbon-nitrogen ratio is really important. Carbon. Now, the source of carbon, as you can remember, that's the brown materials that we've talked about before. The carbon is the carbohydrates are their energy source. And carbon is also a basic building block that goes into a lot of organic molecules. We all know the term carbohydrate. That is normally applied to things that are organic. And carbohydrate. Carbon is involved. The hydrate part is oxygen. If it has a CHO moiety to the chemical, then it's a carbohydrate. And that's why carbon is very important in the compost pile, the amount of carbon you have. It's your energy source, it's a building block. Really, about 50% of the total mass of the microbial cells is carbon. So, carbon is very important. Nitrogen, that's the green materials that we talked about, like the vegetable scraps, the fruit scraps, table scraps, grass clippings, that green type material. That is crucial for a component for cell growth and cell formation. They make proteins, they make nucleic acids, and make amino acids, and make enzymes and coenzymes. Nitrogen is an essential part of all of those things. So without nitrogen, they can't make protein, they can't make nucleic acids, they can't make amino acids, they can't make enzymes, they can't make coenzymes. Essentially, they can't live. Without nitrogen, they're not going to live, they're going to die. They got to have nitrogen. Now, this graph here is a really important one for you to see, because now we're looking at the ratio of carbon to nitrogen and how that affects our compost and our compost pile. This is similar to the one that we've seen before. You can see on the bottom, days of composition, the temperature reached, and so then we've got the different ratios there. Now, if you have a 60-to-1 ratio of carbon to nitrogen, you can see that it doesn't heat up to the temperatures we want it to, and it takes a long time to break down, because with that much carbon, the nitrogen is limiting. As we go up to 40-to-1, now we're getting up close, where it's a pretty good ratio of what we want to see. But you can see again, even at 40-to-1, this is empirical data that has been produced through research, that the temperature doesn't quite get up to where we want it to, and it takes a little bit longer to break down. Even at 40 days, the compost is still breaking down. It hasn't reached the finished curing stage. Now, if we take a 30-to-1 carbon to nitrogen ratio, When you say it heats up to where we want it to, so that the thermophilic bacteria and microorganisms are very happy, they're doing their job, they're working fast, it gets warm enough to kill the pathogenic microbes that are in there, to kill the weed seeds, and it also breaks down very rapidly. So by 40 days, it's already into the good curing stage. So if we can take a look at now a little more explanation of that graphic, it's here on the side, that the carbon-nitrogen ratio is essentially the total mass of the elemental carbon divided by the total mass of elemental nitrogen. We'll see that a little bit later, but we're going to simplify that somewhat. And the ideal ratio is 25 to 1 to 35 to 1. And you see that would fit in. At 25 to 1, it's probably going to heat up a little bit more, break down faster. 35 to 1, you're going to be down in that area where it's still getting hot, but it's breaking down rapidly. Now, if the carbon-nitrogen ratio is less than 20 to 1, that means we've got a lot more nitrogen in comparison to the carbon of the ideal ratio that we want. And so the carbon gets used up really fast for energy and for the building blocks. And so the organisms run out of carbon. But you have excess nitrogen still hanging around. And what happens to that nitrogen? It begins to break to be formed into ammonia, and nitrates, or other things like that, which give off odors. So in a later module, we're going to talk about troubleshooting your compost pile. And one of the things in there is if you have a smell of ammonia, something like that happening, one of the reasons could be that your carbon-nitrogen ratio is too low. So you'll need to add carbon to solve that. Now, if the carbon-nitrogen ratio is too high, say greater than 40 to 1, then it's going to take much longer for the compost to break down because you're limiting nitrogen. Nitrogen, again, as we pointed out earlier, is important for the proteins, for the amino acids, for the DNA. So every time a microorganism divides or replicates in some way, it's got to make more nucleic acids. Without nitrogen, it can't do that. So everything will come to a slowdown, even a standstill, if you don't have enough nitrogen there. So if your carbon-nitrogen ratio is greater than 40 to 1, as you can see in that chart over there, 40 to 1, 60 to 1, things work much more slowly, and it takes a long time for it to happen. So once again, the ideal ratio is somewhere around 25 to 1 to 35 to 1 to get maximum activity and maximum breakdown. Now, this is a table that we put them here so you can get some idea with things that you would put in your compost pile, what the carbon-nitrogen ratio is in each of those things. And as you can see, some things have a very high carbon-nitrogen ratio. Those are the things that we term brown. Those are the brown things that we're talking about, if they have a very high carbon-nitrogen ratio. Some other things have a much lower carbon-nitrogen ratio. Those would be the things that we would consider greens. So when we talk about browns and greens, the browns have a high CN ratio, greens have a lower CN ratio. And just to point out some quick ones, you can see cardboard, that's one that you're probably going to use in your compost pile. It can be anywhere from 200 to 500 to 1 carbon-nitrogen ratio. A good one that a lot of people want to go ahead and spread on their plants right away is coffee grounds. That's a good green because it has a 20 to 1 carbon-nitrogen ratio. And actually, coffee grounds are great for a compost pile, and they're better to put them into your compost pile and let them go through the composting process before you put them into your garden. You get a lot more out of them if you let it go through the composting process before they go into your garden than if you just put them in the garden straight as coffee grounds. But coffee grounds is one with, you know, a very low carbon-nitrogen ratio. Crab and crawfish waste, as Anna mentioned earlier in the module she gave, you may or may not want to put those in your compost pile. But if they're properly treated, you clean them, and you can grind them up, now they're small particle size, they've been cleaned, so there's going to be less chance of odors. They have a pretty low carbon-nitrogen ratio, so those would be another one of the green materials. So you'll have this table available you can look at, and you can see the difference between, you know, what would be considered brown materials have a high CN ratio, green materials have a low CN ratio. So this gives you some idea of looking at it, okay, which things would be really good to balance out? Which ones am I going to call greens? Which ones am I going to call browns? And so like grass clippings, they're green, but that doesn't always, green doesn't always refer to color, but more the carbon-nitrogen ratio. Now you can go, we have this formula here. You can go through all this calculation if you want to figure out your carbon nitrogen ratio. And to do that, you would know, you know, the molecular weight or the actual weight of in the dry material of your carbon in material A plus the weight of the carbon in material B plus the weight of carbon in material C that you're mixing your compost pile, and divide that by the weight of nitrogen in material A, nitrogen in material B, nitrogen in material C. Calculate your carbon nitrogen ratio and then figure out what you might need to add to get it to the right ratio that you want. Or one good rule of thumb, which seems to give in most cases a really good balanced compost pile, is a mixture of 2-to-1 or 3-to-1 browns to greens. And so measure out how many browns you're putting in, and for every 2 browns or every 3 browns that you're adding your compost pile, make sure you're adding at least 1 green to the compost pile, 1 measure of green. So by doing that, you'll come up with usually a pretty good balanced ratio, and you'll get a good compost pile that will heat up and do what it's supposed to, and will give you a nice finished product in a reasonable amount of time. So your choice, do the calculations, or just go with a good rule of thumb like this one, which you have here. So that is one of the parameters that's very important in your compost pile, is the carbon-nitrogen ratio. If you don't get that right, then the other parameters probably aren't going to be as important. So the first thing you're doing as you build your compost pile is making sure you're getting a good mixture of browns to greens, a good mixture that gives you the right carbon-nitrogen ratio. And in subsequent modules now, we're going to talk about other parameters that you need to look at. And as always, remember, go to the Facebook page, post your results, post your questions, and interact with all the other students. You'll have fun.